To hear more, listen to the podcast. Just search for The Pulse of St. Louis.
Welcome back to The Pulse of St. Louis. You know, a local nonprofit called Bright Path STEAM Academy is doing something really amazing. They are teaching children how to conduct research on the COVID-19 virus and how to prevent it from spreading. Take a listen.
And today in my science camp, I learned that it can be really dangerous for like stuff about the coronavirus. If like, say if you put on a mask and you cough in the mask and you never washed it and put it back on again, that's how you can be able to spread germs into your body.
And I also did coronavirus studies. So what I learned in coronavirus studies is, did you know that coronavirus is multiple viruses and COVID-19 is one virus? So coronavirus, when you say that, you mean every other virus there was. Thanks for listening. Bye.
Isn't that so cool? Joining us now, Marcia Brown Rayford. She is founder and president of Bright Path STEAM Academy. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me, Shirley. It's a pleasure.
So tell me, how did Bright Path come about?
Well, Bright Path came about conceptually years ago, back when I was 17 years old, and I was an En-ROADS intern, and I was an intern in as a part of their engineering program, and I interned with Bristol-Myers Products, actually, back in the day. So it started conceptually back then when I thought, okay, somebody's helping me, and one day I want to help other youth. Right now, there is a gap in terms of STEM education or STEAM education, not just within the St. Louis area, but across the country. So we need to plug that skills gap. And I myself am a chemical engineer. I've earned a Bachelor of Science in Chemical Engineering from Washington University, and then did some other things we'll probably talk about in a minute. But I'm paying it forward now to ensure that we enhance STEM/STEAM education for specifically our disenfranchised African-American youth so that they can see people that look like them that have achieved it. I've conducted HIV research and things like that back in the day. And we want our kids to understand that they can do it too and see people of color that are involved in these levels of science and scientific discovery. So that's kind of how it started.
And so how are you going about accomplishing your goal?
Great question. The way I'm going about accomplishing this goal is not to do it alone and not to be a lone ranger. We in the African American community have this saying that goes, it takes a village, right, to raise a child, but it also takes a village and multiple, you know, industries, if you will, to educate a child. And so we have partners, corporate partners. I'm right now currently the vice president of the life sciences practice at a consulting firm called RGP. They're awesome, they're wonderful. They are a sponsor. They sponsored one of the sessions during our summer camp, which was focused on robotics. Bristol-Myers Squibb sponsored the COVID-19 research session. So you're seeing, you know, some images there. And so we also have other corporate partners. We have partners in the faith-based community, specifically Bishop Larry J. Baylor and a pastor attorney, Tommy Harsley III. They are also supporters, key supporters. So we can't do it alone, and we can't have a maverick mentality and approach to educating such a large swath of kids. We had 120 kids that attended a virtual camp, right? And they were glued from the beginning to the end. So we want to also allow them to see that it's not just African Americans that are here to support them, but, you know, people and industries across the gamut that are here to support them. And so that's how we're actually getting it done, in partnership and in collaboration. And we are certainly open for more partnerships out there from a lot of our, you know, partner companies and even from, you know, the political sphere as well. We're open to partnerships to make it happen.
Well, these young scholars are very impressive. I watched the videos that you sent me over and over again, and my heart just swelled with pride. Oh, tell me more about the program that's teaching them how to conduct COVID research. I was like, what? This is so amazing.
Absolutely, absolutely. And so the one thing, Shirley, about teaching COVID research is that we're not teaching it just from theoretics. It's what I do, right? It's what I do. It's what RGP as a firm supports our clients with in terms of their efforts to engage in the battle against COVID-19. And so we are supporting clients in devising and developing and designing diagnostics for COVID-19 antibodies, therapeutics, which are different from vaccines. A vaccine is basically a prophylactic, but a therapeutic, you can call that a cure. And so we're supporting our clients in across the gamut with respect to the research. So I'm actually on the front lines helping to lead that work so then I can translate that to our children and our youth to make it real and to make it practical and to make it applicable to their daily lives in terms of making decisions, teaching them what that curve means. What do you mean by a curve? That's nothing other than statistics, right? Flattening the curve. How they can make decisions in their daily lives to flatten that curve. And so that's how we actually teach it and make it real to them, having them, as you see, to measure distances. Why do we need 6 feet of social distancing? What is that mist that's being sprayed? That's simulated virus, if you will, or a viral load, and they would be able to measure. What's the viral load? There are different viral loads and degrees of infection that can take place. And social distancing and the proximity to someone with the virus can determine how much of a viral load you actually have at the cellular level. These kids are amazing. They're absolutely insanely brilliant. Share these videos with our executives at RGP, as well as Bristol-Myers Squibb, as well as Bank of America that did some sessions on financial literacy. That's a whole other topic. They were just blown away. They're blown away. And when they see these children in action and when they see the passion that these children have and our youth have, folks are just front and center asking, what can we do to help? What can we do to help? So that's how we're making it happen. That's how we make the impact. That's how we engage the youth. And the youth were so over the top enamored that corporate partners and vice presidents of companies had an interest in their STEAM or STEM education and improving and enhancing it. So it's just an exciting time, and I'm just glad to be a part.
Yeah, and then how exciting is it to watch them as they discover their own brilliance and they learn that, hey, I can do this, and it's fun, and they're learning. It's amazing.
Yeah, it really is, because sometimes one of the impacts of racism or being racial, you know, is having the preconceived notion that because of the color of a person's skin, they don't have the propensity, right, to absorb, understand, and engage in levels of whether it's scientific prowess or technical prowess or what have you. I see within these kids myself, and somebody gave me an opportunity. And so to the extent that you can convey that to others who are in positions of power to open doors for these kids, for these youth, I'm in a position of influence, if you will, to provide mentoring and internships for them. But to see the light turn on for these youth, Shirley, is amazing. And you hear things from them like, oh my God, at the end of the camp, we had kids saying, I want to be a scientist now. I want to be an epidemiologist. Now they know what that is. And again, to see people that look like them, that have backgrounds like theirs, that are a part of their community, basically achieve, you know, such feats and such accomplishments, it's just inspiring for them. And it's inspiring for me. It's inspiring for others of us who want to give back. So, you know, we're trying to make room for all the mentors that want to mentor our kids, even with respect to virtual mentoring. So we have now the borderless concept in terms of talent, in terms of mentoring, in terms of instructing and teaching. And we've got folks waiting to mentor these kids because they want to know what they can do. And all you have to do is point and click our leaders and they're ready. So hopefully that answered your question, but I am so super excited about this because I've been doing this since I was 17.
Wow.
Back at Bristol-Myers Products in St. Louis, which is where I got my start. And I'm now returning back to St. Louis from Jersey, Atlanta, and now St. Louis to now give back and dig a well and just kind of create a ladder for those very brilliant kids who are able to do so much given an opportunity.
Well, welcome home, and your well runs deep, and that is a good thing. And I can tell you that exposure is a powerful thing. And as you just mentioned, the kids are now saying, hey, I can be a scientist, I can be an epidemiologist, I can be a doctor. Tell me more about some of the other programs that are offered that are helping to shape these young children.
Absolutely. Some of the other programs, and of course, I'm sure the audience knows what STEM and STEAM represent, but I'm going to tell us. just reiterate, science, technology, engineering, arts, we've included arts, and mathematics. To cut to the chase, the kids, they need, and the youth, and I call them STEAMers, STEAM, so we call them STEAMers to have a brand for themselves. Of course, we know we have the St. Louis STEAMers, or either had or have. I have to kind of, do my homework on the sports arena. But we call them STEAMers. And some of the other programs we have for the STEAMers is a platform for them to be able to dialogue, be mentored virtually, and it is their co-location consistently. So brightpathsteamradio.org is on the way this month, the latter part of this month. And this is where they'll actually create their own content. Radio content, they'll create commercials. So for those of you who out there, you businesses that would allow our STEAMers to create commercials for you, radio technology and things like that, graphic technology, we're coming your way. We'd like for you to allow them an opportunity. In addition, we're looking to engage our STEAMers in helping to rebuild their own community. We're working right now with Glasgow Village with respect to home ownership, mathematics, right? Loans, mortgages, rates, things of that nature. Them putting their hand to the plow to revitalize their community and actually, redevelop some of the homes in collaboration with Bank of America when it comes to increasing home ownership in the region. We are going to allow our STEAMers, front and center opportunity and engagement in shaping their own futures and in impacting their own communities.
And that is awesome. Area. And Marcia, we're out of time, but I want to thank you so much for being here with us. Marcia Brown Rayford, she is founder and president of Bright Path STEAM Academy. Thank you for your efforts. We appreciate you.
Thank you so much, Shirley. Take care now.